In this video, we're going to answer the question, do I need to use insulated tools as an electrician? This question relates to the video we made recently on the 31-piece Slim Vario set from Wiha, which is pretty much Gary's favourite bit of kit ever, so go and check that video out if you haven't watched it already. Now, this kit, along with a vast range of other options, is VDE rated to 1000 volts, but this kind of raises the question, do electricians need to use insulated tools? Well, as always in this wonderful industry of ours, the answer is, it depends. There's really two situations where insulated tools could save you from harm or even a fatality. The first is when you are intentionally working live, and the second is when you are unintentionally working live. Working live is allowed under the legally binding electricity at work regs, but the circumstances have to meet three strict requirements. If just one of these can't be met, then you mustn't work live. We'll cover these in a future Q&A, but if you do end up working live, then insulated equipment is just one of the things in a long line of defences that can help to keep you safe. The Health and Safety Executive in the UK provide us with some information in their document, Electricity at Work, Safe Working Practices, which puts the electricity at work regs into context. If live working is deemed necessary, then there's a list of things that could be implemented to keep you safe. In this list, we find the recommendation that precautions might include using robust and properly insulated tools, CBSEN 60900. Now, the standard reference there is the standard for live working, hand tools for use up to 1000 volts and 1500 volts DC. So using insulated tools that comply with these standards, along with other precautions from the list from the HSE, can help you to protect yourself when you're working live. The other time that insulated tools can help to protect you is when you work live unintentionally. When something goes wrong in a process, which means you accidentally cut a live conductor or similar, and under those circumstances, again, an insulated tool could potentially save your life. So does that mean that electricians should only use insulated tools? Well, let's take the example of a first fix on a brand new property. Is there any chance that you're going to come into contact with a live conductor when you're wiring a house up? Almost definitely not. However, there is a chance that if you're using your best bit of insulated screwdriver, then it's going to wear out more quickly and perhaps take some damage, which could reduce the effectiveness of the insulation when you really need it. So if you're doing work where the chance of contacting a live part with your kit is effectively zero, maybe leave your insulated tools in your box until you're working in situations with increased risk. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you use insulated hand tools for pretty much everything, or do you keep them for the times when you'll need them? Do you think there's ever a valid reason for working live? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments section below, and as always, thank you very much for watching.